Good evening, parents. It's Debbie Richardson, principal of San Jose Middle School. I'm speaking specifically to seventh and eighth grade parents about what our schedule will be like when we return to school after the break. You have probably heard me before explaining the schedule, the AM, PM schedule for return after the break. But as you know, things are a little bit different. In this case, when we return, only sixth graders will be on campus. So sixth graders will be following the schedule as we originally planned. Seventh and eighth graders are going to go to this new schedule, but they are going on remote. So they're going to do this remotely. And it causes a little bit of difference in the way we want to do things for the first 2 weeks. We've explained this to students in their first period classes today, and teachers are going over this schedule over and over again. So your student has been exposed to this schedule, but I wanted to make sure you were aware as well. So I want you to take a look at the schedule and recognize that this is for the time that seventh and eighth grade is doing school still remotely, which is the first 2 weeks. Remember that we are returning to in-person school for seventh and eighth graders. Our scheduled date is January 19th at this time. All right, so let's take a break and look at this schedule. First of all, we want to make sure that all students are aware that as we come back in January, we need students to think about the school day as extending from 8:20 in the morning until 2:45 in the afternoon. Some of that time will be with teachers, and some of that time will be when students are working on their own, on work left for them by their teachers. So again, the Google Classroom, very, very important. So on this schedule, just overall, when you see the bright yellow, that means that your student should be Zooming at that time. So those are all mandatory Zooms. Let's take a look at what we're going to be doing here. At 8:20 in the morning, we are asking all seventh and eighth grade students to log on to their first period Zoom. We're going to ask all students, not just cohort A. Cohort A and B will log on during first period. Then at 9:25, they will log on, both cohorts will log on to their third period class. And then there's a break. They can be doing asynchronous work in here, or they could take a break and then do some reading. Then in fifth period, both cohorts will log on to their fifth period class. So students will be going to first, third, and fifth period online. Then they should have some lunch. At 12:45, we're going to ask them to go back to their first period class. Cohorts A and B will go back to their first period class. During this time, the teacher will supervise asynchronous work for all of their classes, because students will be doing asynchronous work, work they do on their own, for second, fourth, and sixth periods, and we want them to be in a supervised environment for that. This is one thing that we have found has been very difficult for students to do the asynchronous work on their own. So we're going to ask them to return to their first period class. Roll will be taken. We are expecting students to be there. Also, the teacher will be offering support and answering questions for students on their own subject matter. And then after that, we are asking students to return to their third period class for the same activity. Asynchronous work supervised by their teacher, additional support in the subject matter by the teacher. So that's what a Monday looks like. Let's just go a little bit further and look at Tuesday just to review, and I know it's a lot, but let's do it one more time. On Tuesday, both cohorts, A and B, will log on to their second period class at 8:20 in the morning. That will be followed by their fourth period class. Both cohorts, A and B, will log on at 9:25. Then there is a lot of time in here where students can be working on their asynchronous work, also getting some reading done and eating some lunch. At 12:45, they log on again to their second period class. Roll will be taken. It is mandatory time for a student to be there, and they will be supervised as they do asynchronous work. Fourth period, again, at 1:50, you'll return to your fourth period class for asynchronous work and additional support. This schedule will run for at least 2 weeks until we are scheduled to return on the 19th. It's a great way for students to get used to this new schedule and to receive additional support and get off to a great start for the second semester. So even though it seems a little confusing, I do want us to be happy about the fact that this gives our students extra time with their teachers so that they get off to a good start before we get back to school. If there's any questions, you can maybe ask your student because they've also gone over this as well, or send us an email. We'll be happy to help. Thank you for your time. Looking forward to a great holiday, and I hope you have a good holiday as well.